Hi, and welcome to the Wix Engineering's Tech Talk Show. I'm sure you've all heard about solid principles for so many times, but it's not always clear what they mean, right? My name is Fayga, and I'm a software developer at Wix. And today, I'm going to show you those principles with a bunch of simple examples I'm sure you can all understand. Those five simple principles were originally written by Robert Martin, and since then, they've helped a lot of developers to become a much better object-oriented programmers. The first principle is single responsibility principle.
A class should have only one reason to change.
A class is what a class does. The more class does, the more likely it will be changed. The more class changes, the more likely it will introduce bugs. This is why we need to keep in mind that a class should have only one responsibility. This code was absolutely fine until the day I wanted to add write to the shape. I want that write method to write this shape into a file. Now our shape is doing two entirely separate things, drawing and writing. When the latter changes, all the class was compromised, despite the fact the drawing was the same. The solution is to make drawing and writing two separate classes. Thanks to this separation, it will be easy to change shape, whether writing or drawing logic needs to be changed. The second principle is open-closed principle.
Software entities should be open for extension and closed for modification.
It means that new behavior comes with new code, not by changing the old one. Back to my example. Let's take a look on how Writer is implemented. What if I would like to change the library I use to write with? What if I would like to print to the screen instead of writing to a file?
In either of those options, concrete implementation details of Writer would have to change.
So how do we achieve it? Rely on abstractions. Whether it's full abstraction, like interface, or partial abstraction, like abstract file, the solution would be to abstract Writer. Here we can see that interface Writer with two different detailed implementations. Remember, abstractions are always better than referencing concrete classes. The third principle is Liskov substitution principle.
Subtypes must be substitutable for their base types.
Well, basically it means that if you want to replace a class with a subtype class, the behavior should stay the same. Let's go back to our example. Here we have a rectangle that has two properties, width and height, and also one method called calcArea.
Now for this square. Although a square is a rectangle, it has some different behavior. Square has the same value for width and height.
Take a look at the test here. Do you see what's wrong? Although the client expected to get 18, he gets 9. And this is exactly Liskov substitution violation.
Square and rectangle are not substitutable.
A proper solution would be that both square and rectangle would implement interface shape. Here, shape has only calcArea and it won't hold any size properties like width and height. Then the square could have only one property. The fourth principle is interface aggregation principle.
Classes that implement interfaces should not be forced to implement methods they do not use.
Another way to say it, use small interfaces, not fat ones. Let's illustrate it. Suppose shape has all of these different abilities, color, move, rotate, and suppose not all shapes have them.
Clients should not be forced to depend upon interfaces that they do not use.
Instead of creating a shape and throwing an exception when it doesn't have the specific ability, we just need to separate all of these abilities into separated interfaces. We can easily compose the right behavior for each shape with composing those interfaces together. The fifth and last principle is dependency inversion principle.
High-level modules should depend on abstractions and not on details.
Now back to our example. Remember Writer? Writer was dependent on how we write into a file in Java. The solution was to abstract out Writer and separate it from the specific logic. This is called inverting the dependency. Instead of depending on a specific implementation, we are dependent on an interface.
This allows us to swap implementation or even mock Writer class very easily.
So to conclude, this last principle sums it all up. So if you liked my presentation so far, there is a bunch of simple principles I'm sure you'll be thrilled to read about. And remember, use those principles wisely. In real life, situations are much more complicated. So hold those in mind and come up with the best solution you can. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any question or a comment, just leave it here below and I'll be happy to answer. See you at the next week's Tech Talk shows. Bye-bye.